studying the book of Romans, Romans chapter 9. If you want to open up your Bible there, that would be great. We're going to be catching some of the verses that we've already reviewed over, or already looked at, and then we're going to catch up to where we're at this evening. So, before we get started, I want to open with a word of prayer, and then we will proceed from there. So, let's pray. Father, tonight morning, we gather as the people being here. Lord, this is an unprecedented time in our nation. And Lord, we know this, that you have control of everything that's going on. So, we thank you for that. Father, tonight I pray that those who are listeners tune in. Father, whether it be tonight, whether it be tomorrow, whether it be days from now, Lord, that Father, may you open our hearts and our minds and help us to be receptive to the teaching of the Spirit of God. Lord, I pray that you would guide our lips tonight, my time, Lord, that we might just teach anything that is contrary to your word. Lord, I want to teach the truth and help our people to be able to understand the truth of your word. Father, we are in worship of form. Your word is deep. Lord, it is at times it is challenging to understand. But Father, you've recorded it. You've had it to be recorded by the Apostle Paul. It's not there for us just to read through, but it's there for us to learn from and to grow. Lord, if we discern the depth, the deep truth of the word, I know that you will give them to us. And Lord, tonight I'm here to say, I don't understand completely what it is that is before us, so that I can bring it back and teach it to our people. Lord, I pray for all of our peoples who are spread out, Lord, that you would keep everybody safe, protected from the virus. We'll keep them all safe. Lord, we pray that soon we would be able to gather back together here in this building to be able to praise and worship our Savior Jesus Christ. So, Lord, this evening, Father, we ask your blessing upon what we're about to study. We pray it all now in Jesus' name. Amen. Last time we were together, I went back and I checked out the video of what I had said, and I thought I said the rest of it earlier this evening. I said, boy, that sounded kind of dumb. I said, good to see everybody. I couldn't see everybody, but some of you listening, you're probably wondering, you know, what was in the auditorium. I'll tell you this. So the two guys in there now besides me, that's it for the recording. As you know, this is in this time that we're going through, it's a learning lesson from it. And I just have to share this with you. One of the things I'm learning from all of this is I work with my wife. It's kind of a time take because whenever we're in the process, we're trying to put ceiling up on our porch. It's time we've gone ahead and made a decision that someone's falling by. And I'm a firm pastor. I think that if we want to know a young couple and they're looking to get married for a premarital, one of the premarital kinds of things that I think would be really good would be that they'd have to put a time with buying ceiling up together. And if they survive that, then it's going to be a survival marriage. And if you've ever worked together with a husband and a wife and something that you're not used to, you understand completely what I am talking about. I've had somebody that I know with has used the D-word before us, but dangerous, dumb, destructive. I've heard all of those words when we work together. So, as always, it's good to be here tonight to be able to teach God's word, but it's really good after working on that sin to get in here tonight. It certainly is. So, I have about 20 seconds on it. And I'm trying on it. And also, I have put the, you can see behind me, I've put the verses up on the screen. So that if you don't have the notes in front of you, if you have a big old screen, you'll be able to follow along there. The sitting bell that goes with the notes is always done. I'm going to reference the notes where I stop, and I will expand upon some of them as we go through. We're going to cover one grand tonight. This is a tool for me to be able to catch us up in very difficult portion of scripture to be able to pull it together so that you can understand. So I want to get to the introduction myself. I would say, if you want to follow along, if you want to listen, however you want to do it, that's the same. We're going to say in Romans 9, we're going to look at the sovereignty of God and the choosing of the nation of Israel. If that may be able to come back to that. Paul teaches us what is recorded here for several reasons. It's a question as to what happened to the prophets in the promises God made to was in that desire. After Israel was born in all the desire, and God wanted something else to do, and God wanted to honor the promises, and God was finished now. Genesis 17, 15 to 19, as you remember, and God said, I will be here. This is Sarah, and God was not Sarah, God was not Sarah, so my prayer is Sarah, and Sarah said, I'm going to go to the hospital. Thank you. is preferred over the other. And to get that, there is an absolute. Power is in the living room, or in the living room. No one in the living room, as well as in the living room, unless you have a sense of somewhere. David says that he does not want to go from the living room, or in the room. She is not going to be able to use the same as hatred. But we have to watch the same preferred over the other ways. But in the sense of that is about 14, 24, 26, the final word here, I would have been compared to, specifically, bring all the Jews with them, as with Jesus, he told them so to them, the same God could really bring his father and mother and all his children and bring his sisters. And in his own words also, he cannot be found with sin and all. But it is together. If you're going to take that as an absolute, and you're going to say, what we're going to do, I'm going to despise her father, I'm going to despise her mother, I'm going to despise her spouse and children, her brother and her sisters, and her wife. Rather than all that you call my brother, because that is fine. He doesn't hear us, and it's not your teach, that I have a good tradition of scripture. You can read that. She says, Jesus is sitting here for you, and it tells us, come on, it is the same to bring us to our father, and we have two big brothers, the sisters. Yes, this is meant to be absolute. There is a problem. There's a problem, as I'm going to say in the verses on the screen, I'm reading again.
Thank you.
things on purpose. There's no favoritism here. This man looks so after. Nobody can invent the names of the heaven. Make sure somebody has a question. This is what I want to get. Why is all of this required? Well, I can't help this. But they just have this disabled woman. Why is this their coffee answer? Because there was much confusion. Thank you. Thank you. I'm